My name's Gavin.
I'm Andrew.
And we made the cube. We named it the Oontz cube.
It's basically a 3x3x3 cube with LEDs, 27 LEDs, and we have them set up so that the LEDs go on and off at different patterns so that it displays different displays. For the requirements, you have to provide proper circuitry so that the LEDs illuminate according to the signal set for the CMOS, obviously. And then the thing with putting LEDs in parallel is that, is that if you have them on at the same time, you'll short out one of them. And so if you ever want to have LEDs in parallel going on at the same time, you actually have to trick your eyes into thinking that they're on, but they're actually blinking faster than your eyes can understand. And so that's what multiplexing is. And you have to understand the different components of the LEDs, because they aren't just two leads. There is one cathode, one anode. Learned it the hard way. And you have to use a timer to read button into it, obviously, and then be able to solder efficiently and properly so that all the LEDs get the correct signals.
So for our hardware, we just have a standard micro blades right there, and then it's just we just have two GPIOs. One is just a button which basically toggle it, you change the pattern. The next one is the feature, which is basically our whole cube. And these are this whole thing is connected to it's connected to three layers of LEDs, and these BJTs are used to toggle which layer you want to see.
So basically one of them chooses what layer is going to turn on and the other one chooses which column turns on. So then that's the way you can pinpoint exactly which LEDs you want to show. And then for the flowchart, on startup all the lights should turn on, and then button zero is the one that we use to toggle, and then so if that one's turned on, we'll go to the next sequence. If it doesn't, it'll just remain there. Then the next sequence, we'll ask the same question. Yes, you go to the next pattern, then we go the same pattern, just loop around.
And for integration and testing, we actually soldered it. It works with a power supply, but when we actually drive it into the Nexus port, we actually don't have enough power. And we just figured that out today, actually. Yeah, so our LEDs are pretty dim right now.
Yeah, we had problems with the LEDs just shorting them out,
yeah,
which I did a couple
a lot
times. And then another time we accidentally put the wrong color LED in, so then we had to take it out and put it back in. And so the soldering and understanding the components of the LEDs were parts where we struggled in.
Yeah. And Radio Shack had a limited amount of LEDs. Pretty much, I guess we pretty much bought this.
So we know that Nexus board can connect up to our cube, because upon startup, you'll see that it does light up. And then now it's just a matter of getting the patterns to be processed and to display exactly how we'd like it to. And, we should probably turn off the lights to trip.
You're testing today.
It was between the program. And well, putting the cube together, which was our biggest problem, and then having the code actually work out. Because we weren't sure if it was the code that was
the best. All the program that we have right now.
And to prove that our circuitry works,
it's going to give me a. It's going to light whichever LED I want on. And then all I'd have to do is on another layer.
So you're not that far in terms of having a 3D display.
Yeah, not quite yet, but
yeah, but I mean, the idea is.
Yeah.